Peace of the Lord be with you. Good morning. This is our devotion for Thursday, February 25th, and it's Psalm Day, so we'll be reading Psalm 121. And not all that long of a psalm, it's 8 verses, but one that's really comforting, I think. It's a good reminder of God, the God who cares for us, the God who is our help, and that's what our faith rests in as we look at the faith of the Canaanite woman this week. So we'll begin. The morning order, page 295 of the hymnal. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the morning, O Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning I prepare a sacrifice for you and watch. My mouth is filled with your praise and with your glory all the day. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. All right, Psalm 121. I lift my eyes up to the hills. From where does my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade on your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time forth and forevermore. Let us pray. Blessed God, our Heavenly Father, we lift our eyes up to you. We lift our eyes up to you because you are the one from whom our help comes. May our help always come from you as you have made heaven and earth. For you will not let our foot be moved. You who keep us will not slumber. You who keep Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. You are our keeper. You are our shade on our right hand. The sun shall not strike us by day nor the moon by night. You will keep us from all evil. You will keep our life. You will keep are coming out, going out and are coming in from this time forth and forevermore. And we give you thanks that these promises are all ours through your Son, Jesus, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. All right. This is, I expect to be fairly brief here because it's so straightforward, but so comforting. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where does my help come? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. You know, where do we look? In this idea of lifting up eyes, lifting up, Psalm 21 says, I lift up my soul to you, I lift up my soul, and then it gives us an indication what that means. That just means to trust. I probably pointed this out before, but look at Psalm 25, verses 1 and 2. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. Oh my God, in you I trust, right? That's, when you have the Psalms, in these pairs like that, where you have pairs in the Psalms, that's they're couplets, and that's the poetry of the Psalms. You know, we think of poetry as rhyming. I'm sure I've said this before, but you think of poetry as rhyming, but with the Psalms, it's poetry because Hebrew poetry is this pairing of these phrases that are often sort of they're pairings, and often they're sort of different ways of saying the same thing, right? So you see it here. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. There's that coupling there, right? But the coupling in Psalm 25 tells us, "To you I lift up my soul, oh my God, in you do I trust," right? That lifting up isn't, it's not this sort of us floating up kind of thing. It's the lifting our eyes up to God, and ultimately it's that trusting in Him. You know, it doesn't have to be a literal looking up. It's the trust. So where is our trust? It's in the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Do you think that the God who made heaven and earth isn't powerful? Do you think He's not worthy of our praise and our care? That's where our trust is. And continuing to explain that, right? What does that mean? Well, it means that He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. You know, God never sleeps. I'll every once in a while make a joke that, if something happens, like, really in the middle of the night, I say, well, God's not even awake at that time. And obviously I'm kidding because God never slumbers. He's always awake, and He's always watching over us. Behold, he who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep, right? You know, he will not slumber. You're not going to catch Him off guard. Or you think about Elijah and the prophets of Baal, and he teases the prophets of Baal, when they're waiting for the fire to come down and the acceptance of their sacrifice, and he says, where's your God? Oh, maybe he's in the bathroom, right? Maybe he's relieving himself. No, our God is always, he's not sleeping, he's not relieving himself. We don't have to worry that he's not paying. He's there, and of course, as we wrestle with the theme for this week of that faith, you know, this is the confession that we don't have to worry about that he doesn't slumber or sleep. He isn't in the bathroom. He's well aware of what's going on. So why doesn't he answer? We don't know, but we know that it's out of that love, like I keep saying, because he is our keeper. And as he, you know, we have that fear that he's not answering in those times. This is what we cling to, that he is still keeping us, that he is still guarding, protecting us. He is our shade on our right hand. The Lord is your shade on your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night, right? And of course, as we hear some of these promises, understanding what that means, that doesn't mean you won't get sunburned, right? Doesn't mean that you might not hurt yourself in the middle of the dark or something right now. But the Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. That's the, you know, as it was mentioned that yesterday, deliver us from evil. Of course, I mentioned specifically, lead us not into temptation, but that prayer, lead us, deliver us from evil. You know, that God keeps us from that. He protects us. He's won the victory over the evil one in the cross. He crushed the head of the serpent, and so that victory is ours. It's yours in your baptism, because that word does what it says, and he gives that to you. So, the Lord keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time forth and forevermore. You know, and that's that protection isn't something that's just now. In that faith that he keeps you, it continues. It goes on from this time forth and forevermore. And so again, when we put this in the context of the reading of this week, the wrestling with God, you know, we might have those times where we wrestle with God, you know, but it's better to wrestle with the God who cares for us than the devil who doesn't, right? And let God wrestle the devil and overpower him. You know, that what peace we have in that. You know, I often think about the challenge of our sin. You know, when we wrestle with our sin, the realization that in our sin, our problem is with God. As we hear the voice of God and his law condemning us, you know, our problem is with God, but where is our solution? It's with that same God. It's running to him, not running away from him, but running to him. And when we get come into his presence, seeing that he has cleansed us to enter that presence in Christ, where he would guard and keep us, where he would be that shade on our right hand, that shield, or strengthen our shield, as it says in the Psalms, the very present help in times of trouble, as it says in Psalm 46, right? That he is the one who cares for us. Amen. All right, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I thank you, my heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have kept me this night from all harm and danger. And I pray that you would keep me this day also from sin and every evil, that all my doings in life may please you. For into your hands I commend myself, my body and soul in all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. And hope everybody has a good weekend. And look forward to having you join us either in person or over YouTube for our service Sunday. And God's blessings be with you in your weekend.